Breaking news. The membership of the Edo State chapter of the All Progressive Congress swelled on Saturday as the reinstalled Deputy Governor of the state, Philip Shaibu, alongside prominent members with their supporters, dumped the People's Democratic Party. The dumping, which took place in Benin at the inauguration of the National Campaign Council by the APC National Chairman, Abdoulaye Ganduje, put an end to several months of speculations over Shaibu's continuous stay in the PDP. The Deputy Governor, as we all know, fell out with his principal, Governor Godwin Obaseki, over his ambition to succeed him as the next governor of the state, and was impeached after he lost to Asue Yodalo in the PDP primaries. He was, however, reinstalled by the court on Wednesday by the Abuja High Court, and this has further caused division between Obaseki and him. Speaking at the event, Shaibu had said he was back to the APC to add value, and noted that at this point, on behalf of the legacy group, they announced their movement to the APC and they are back to add value to the party, and noted that they are the homeboys of Edo State and they are ready to take back their state through the APC candidate Monday Okpebolo and his running mate Dennis Idahosa. So Ganduje, while inaugurating the National Campaign Council of the party for the September 21st governorship election, headed by the Cross River State Governor Bassey Otu, had received the defectors. The APC National Chairman said since Shaibu was a serving governor, the party had 50% of the people of Edo State. He disclosed the party would organize a grand rally in Benin to be attended by President Bola Tinubu, saying that the APC governorship candidate Senator Monday Okpebolo and his running mate Dennis Idahosa are not coming with MOUs but with concrete plans to develop Edo State and to connect the state to the center. Also speaking, Oshomole, a senator representing Edo North, lamented that development legacy recorded by the administration in all sectors of the state had not been sustained by the Obaseki's government, where he said Okpebolo's major strength is empathy because he contributed millions to boost security in Ishan lands years back. Speaking on the recent attack on Philip Shaibu and Monday Okpebolo's convoy, which claimed the life of a police inspector, Oshomole called on the State Commissioner of Police to defend the integrity of his uniform by producing the killers of this police officer. While wishing Shaibu well in the official endeavors, the chairman of the PDP in the state had noted that those who were calling to join the party after Shaibu's exit were more than those leaving, and wished them best of luck in their official endeavors. But then, the PDP is not shaken by this move. Every vote counts. The PDP is not shaken by this move. So the PDP have said at this point, Shaibu's defection to the APC would not change anything. It won't change the votes that would be going to Asue Yodalo. The PDP have noted that they will still win the election. You know, recently, Governor Godwin Obaseki, while meeting with leaders of the People's Democratic Party from each ward across the 18 local government areas of the state to strategize ahead of the governorship elections holding on September 21st, boasted that his party is ready to take the state once again, and said that despite the distractions, Asue Yodalo is being celebrated nationwide as the best among the best in Edo State, and is convinced that with all efforts, Asue Yodalo will emerge as the next governor of Edo State come September 21st, 2024. And the parties is ready for anything. They are not afraid because they know they will win the election. And noted that every person, you know, all hands are on deck to see to the victory of Asue Yodalo in Edo State. This is coming as Philip Shaibo dumped the People's Democratic Party and went to the All Progressive Congress. Philip Shaibo's defection has been trending on the social media space. This comes as Shaibo lost out at the PDP governorship primaries, which saw to the victory of Aswe Yodalo emerging as the flag bearer of the party ahead of the Guba elections in the state. I'm sure Philip Shaibo wouldn't have made this move had it been he emerged as the winner of the party's primary. He wouldn't have decamped. He would have still remained loyal to the party. But because the party did not give him that chance, because Obaseki was not in support of his ambition, Obaseki said Shaibu was desperate. And we are seeing signs, obvious signs, that Shaibu is indeed desperate. He's a desperate man. Because only a desperate man would go back to his vomit. Someone that, you know, went ahead and was bowing down before Adams Oshiomhole, whom he once betrayed. Out of desperation, Philip Shaibu has gone back to the APC. Had it been Shaibu clinched to the party's tickets, Shaibu would have been praising the PDP by now, leaving Aswe Yodalo to his fate. But no, because he did not clinch to the party's tickets, he went ahead, betrayed the party, engaged in anti-party activities, and now has finally dumped the party. But Obaseki seems to be unshaken by this move. The PDP seems to be unshaken by this move, even Aswe Yodalo. I mean, amid all these tensions in the state, Aswe Yodalo is yet to make comments on Shaibu's betrayal of the People's Democratic Party in the states. So, Philip Shaibu has defined his path. He has defined his future. He has shaped his future with the All Progressive Congress. Let's see where that leads him in the nearest future. Let's see what he seeks to gain or what he will stand to gain in the nearest future, because it will be a big shame to Philip Shaibu if Aswe Yodalo, you know, finally wins the election. It would be a big shame to Shaibu, to the APC, and other PDP faithfuls that decamped from the party to the All Progressive Congress because of their ambition, because of their selfish ambition. So the PDP have trashed Obaseki's Shaibu's defection, noting that it wouldn't affect the votes of the PDP, it wouldn't affect the chances of the PDP becoming victorious or emerging victorious ahead of the elections. Guys, I'm dropping here. Kindly share your thoughts on this in the comment section. Thank you.